I'm on my way to go meet this guy. I guess you can call it a date. I try not to label it as a date. I try to label it as like just meeting someone and then potentially being a friend or whatever. I wanted to talk about why gay relationships are hard. I would say gay relationships are definitely much harder than heterosexual relationships, because I think it's harder to meet people in a heterosexual relationship. You automatically assume that male likes female and vice versa. But when you meet people, a very high percentage of that are going to be straight people. I mean, unless you live in like a gay district or a gayborhood or somewhere where there's a high population of gay people. But generally speaking, like, there's not that many places that are like that. But yeah, I was just helping my friend move this morning, and I'm about to meet this guy. We're just going to have a coffee at a cafe, and we're gonna go for a walk because it's such a nice day today. Whenever you go on a date with someone that you haven't met before, I think it's really important to just take all the pressure off. And that's why we're going for a coffee during the daytime instead of like a sit-down dinner, because I don't know if we're going to hit it off or have things in common. And the typical way of going on a date, like going to a fancy restaurant and having a sit-down dinner, and I'm all for that and I do like that, but I feel like meeting someone for the first time in that kind of environment just puts so much pressure into the date. Whenever I've gone on dates that were like that, the whole thing just felt like an interview, basically. I want to go on a date and just get to know someone in a chilled environment. And if there's a good vibe and there's chemistry there, then I would be more open to going on like a sit down dinner where it's a little bit more romantic. I just got home from meeting the guy, and we were actually meant to go for a walk after lunch, but I just wasn't vibing it, so I decided to just leave after that. I'm not gonna say anything about the guy's personality or anything like that, because I feel like everyone is different in their own way, but I'm just gonna say that we didn't vibe and the energy wasn't right for me. And if there's one thing that I can give an advice on in regards to meeting new people or going out on a date, is that your energy is so important. Protect your energy, and if the energy doesn't feel right or it just doesn't feel good, don't be scared to leave. And you don't have to do it in a rude way as well. So what I normally like to do is I use the toilet excuse. So I will find a moment where the conversation goes quiet, and then I will excuse myself to go to the toilet. And that sort of just kind of like gives you time to think a little bit as well. And then when I come back, I usually will say, oh, you know, should we go? And yeah, that's what I did today, actually. So I didn't say it in a rude way, but I also didn't want to continue the interaction if my energy didn't feel right. And you're definitely allowed to do that. You don't have to spend your time with someone if you don't want to. But in saying that though, there are a few key things that I do look for in a date. I feel like as you get older, you just don't settle for anything less. And if you meet people that don't have the qualities that you're after or that you vibe with, then that's fine, each to their own. I guess whenever I meet someone new, I always look for a lighter interaction, like something that's a bit more jokey and playful. I like to, you know, I think I'm pretty funny. I mean, obviously everyone thinks they're funny. But yeah, I like to infuse a little bit of humor in our conversations, and I like to kind of joke around and don't take it as seriously. And I don't really want to talk about, like, you know, general conversations like, oh, where did you grow up? What do you do for work? Blah, blah, blah. Obviously that's important, but there are more to people than like their job or where they grew up. I think us gay people, it's hard when you're dating because there's not that many of us and our dating pool is a lot smaller. So I think oftentimes it's possible to fall into a trap of, oh, I'll make this date work, or maybe I'll get to know this person a little bit more because I can't find anyone, because it's hard to find someone when you're gay and your dating pool is a lot smaller. But honestly, you will find someone, and I believe that Truly, I believe that. You don't have to settle for anything less because you will meet those people that you enjoy spending time with. You're laughing, but you can also talk about serious things, and those people will come around. You just have to be open to meeting different people, and if it doesn't work out, that's fine. There's nothing wrong with that. My friend that I helped move this morning lent me his speaker set. So I'm gonna go install that. I think I need to clean it first. Go ahead and clean that. Oh, all right. I'm going to the cinema with a friend tonight. We're gonna be watching A Quiet Place 2. I'm really excited for that actually, because I really, really like the first one. And I love horror movies. Good morning. It is a Sunday morning and it's actually raining outside. Well, not at the moment, but this morning I woke up because it was raining so loud. I really thought it'd be a nice sunny day today, but can't really predict that in Sydney. I am meeting with someone for coffee. We've been talking for a couple of weeks now on Tinder and he's pretty funny. He's really funny, actually. I've always had short hair, so I don't really know how to style it, but my outfit is just a simple black t-shirt and then some baggy jeans. I'm actually going to wear my favorite jacket with this, which is this bomber jacket in army green. So I'm just here chilling at a coffee shop by myself. I drove past this little coffee shop and I thought I'd try it out. It's pretty good. So we're about to meet in an hour or so. So I thought I'd just come here and chill and relax by myself. I don't actually mind spending time on my own at coffee shops. I think it's actually quite nice. It's so relaxing and quiet and peaceful, especially today. It's a gloomy and rainy day today. So it's a good time to spend inside at a coffee shop. Oh. It's just got really busy. When you go on a date, I think it's really important to just completely be yourself. Oftentimes, we try to be someone else because we want to impress the other person or we want them to think a certain way about us. If you're meeting people to make genuine connections and to genuinely like what you talk about, why pretend to be someone else? I definitely did that when I was younger or even a few years back. I definitely went on dates and pretended to be someone I'm not, or pretended to have a different kind of personality or withhold things I wanted to say because I was scared of what they would think. But now, I really don't care. As long as I'm being respectful and I'm not being rude, I honestly will just say what I think and I will just completely be myself. And if we don't get along because of that, or if the vibe is wrong because of that, then that's actually a good thing, because you don't want to be surrounding yourself with people that don't really get you or are not in the same wavelength as you. So I just got back from having coffee with that guy and it went really good, actually. It went really, really good. He's very cute, he's tall, which is what I like. He was really funny and we gelled really well together. Like, we were throwing jokes back and forth and I was able to be completely myself, which is the biggest thing. Yeah, we had such a good time, like, that we even got kicked out because the cafe that we went to only had a certain time that you can sit at because they're so busy. And then the barista was like, "So, sorry, but you guys have to leave now." So I'm just about to head home now and I wanted to give you one last tip when it comes to dating. So obviously I had a good time today and I really enjoyed, you know, meeting with a guy, and I even said I would like to do it again and he said the same thing. You know, you had a good time the first time you met, but what about the second, third, fourth time? Like, you don't really know them that well yet. Don't obsess too much about dates going on well and just think that that date went well and I had such a great time and I would like to do it again, but if it doesn't happen the way I want to, or if the person doesn't feel the same way, or nothing comes out of it, then it's fine. Like, you had a great time and you had a good experience at that moment. I guess to finish off, I'll just say that when you go on dates and you're dating around and meeting new people, just have fun. As long as you're having fun, that's the main thing. And if you're not having fun, then exactly what I said about energy. Protect that energy. Don't do things that you don't find fun.